Hello everyone, good morning, this is Vineet Pandey and I'm going to record a review video for all of you related to the last result which got declared on the day before yesterday. Friends, I was thinking that what should be my language for this particular video, because there are certain lines I'm going to say which may offend many of you. I am personally not happy. This time I got the biggest result. 276 students plus students qualified from my classes, from my online batch. No doubt it's an amazing result. There are many people qualified. It became really hectic for me to pick all those calls, and trust me, it was quite impossible to answer all those chats. Sir, I qualified. Sir, congratulations, I qualified. It became really hectic for me, and the video will be watched by my online students and they will say yes, because sir didn't say any word till now. I'm answering maximum people, and this time I think it has crossed approximately 320 students in total, like the last batches of online and offline 276 plus, and the previous students those who have started telling me. No doubt in coming days they will tell me again. So what my concern was, as a teacher, as a professor, why did I say that my language will offend you? As Vineet Pandey, as an aspirant who has obtained NET for many times and qualified, who has got double GRF, who keeps on studying and who has created a name, from my point of view, I am not happy. Why I'm not happy is because of this paper 1 pattern. Many of my students, those who missed this exam, it was because of paper 1. My students, they got good marks in paper 2, paper 3, but just because of the tricky pattern where we have 10 questions which were eliminated this time, they got stuck. Sometimes they couldn't manage the time and they got overstressed because of 10 questions lost this time. So I found many people, those who were deserving, even I got shocked for many of the students, because I said it was obvious that you will qualify. Second thing, here in this video I am requesting UGC to make this UGC NET paper sensible, because when they create this insensible paper asking stupid questions from all the corners, only my people qualify, my students qualify, because I prepare them in that way. But what about others, people coming from this background, coming from villages? I'm in a very small town here. I'm talking to people in Varanasi, meeting them, and I'm trying to understand their actual condition, how they are appearing in NET exam. I was shocked to know that people hardly know anything after T.S. Eliot. Even the students from BHU, I met 4 or 5 girls yesterday. They had no idea of the writers who were European writers, and they don't know anything in depth of feminism. All they know is feminism, something related to women's rights. So this is how we cannot prepare, we cannot qualify. So what I mean to say is that no doubt the result is good. We have created the parallels, we have got the result which is up to the mark. But still, we have to work a lot. Miles to go before I sleep, miles to go before I sleep. I am not happy with this result, because I wanted maximum people, those who missed this by paper 1, they should have qualified. But it's because of tricky things that paper 1, and they couldn't get out of those stresses, they did mistakes. One of my students, one of the best students, she just got 22 marks in paper 1. And how stupid is that? She got good marks in paper 2 and 3, 94 in paper 3. So that's why I'm not happy. Well, we have next attempt. As John Milton has said, that what though the field be lost, all is not lost. So we are going to fight back once again. If you remember Robert Browning, he said, I was ever a fighter, so one fight more, the best and the last. So be with me. Let me guide you. I'm the torchbearer. Follow my path and I'm sure you will qualify. As you have seen the last result, you can be the next phase. You can be the next result. Thank you so much. Stay tuned on my number 85870-35827. God bless you.